situation. They're going to rotate goaltenders, but that's something they've done all year. Mrazek is Soderblom yesterday. 3-1 loss to Winnipeg. Now it's Mrazek. Respectable numbers, 5-7 on the year with a .900 save percentage.
Foligno on it for Minnesota. In behind for Gaudreau. Back to Foligno in the circle. His shot was blocked. Merrill holds his own. Merrill's long shot gloved by Mrazek.
They're prone to leaving guys open, so the more patient the Wild are in the offensive zone, I think the higher quality chances they'll get.
Zuccarello, second shift for Minnesota's top line. Faber, a long shot, they score! It was tipped out front by Rossi, and Minnesota leads it 1-0.
Faber with a quick shot. Rossi again, left alone, out in front. Beautiful little backhand tip. Change of direction. Like the positioning there, too. Enough distance from the net.
Goal scored by a rookie, assisted by a rookie in Brock Faber, and Minnesota leads 1-0. Rossi fires again, and a glove save by Mrazek. Noligoski knocked off the puck behind the Minnesota net. Entwistle has it for Chicago. Dickinson, defended by Duehr, plays it out to the line. A long shot got through. Saved by Fleury. Out to the line, a long shot deflected out front. Picked up in the corner by Johnson, around for Bedard. Back to the line for Jones. Now Bedard. Johnson tried to go across for Kurashev, who was sneaking in on the back door. Bedard has it again. Johnson fires from a sharp angle, and that's deflected up and out of play by him. See some of the numbers on the Minnesota penalty kill. They've been perfect over two games. Some of the deeper analytics tell you it's not a fluke. Here, a loose puck. Fleury sprawling back, and it's deflected out to the line. Jones holds. Blackhawks have had a couple good looks on this power play. Bedard moves in. Fire! Saved by Fleury. Rebound loose. Fleury trying to find the puck. Still alive. And the Blackhawks come up with it with Bedard. Bedard centers, tipped on goal, saved by Fleury. Limited attempts and high danger chances. That was not the case on this kill. It was simply Fleury brilliance.
Yeah, they lost their form a little bit. They're getting Brodin shading to that goal line attack side. Chicago set that up. That left
to the line for Jones. And now Bedard with it. Johnson at the side of the net. Kurashev fires, sliding save by Fleury. Zuccarello tried to go cross ice. Noligoski manning the point with Spurgeon out with an injury. Plastic in shorthanded, cuts to the middle, and a save by Fleury. Boldy carries back for Minnesota. Johansson to Gaudreau. Gaudreau moves in, finds some room, fires on goal, saved by Mrazek. Rossi got it out to Faber at the line. Gaudreau, Rossi scores! The Minnesota rookies on the board twice. It's 2-0 Wild.
As they win this puck battle, it goes high. Chicago forward on their horse to get out. Down low, then the pop. Chicago forward cannot recover in time. There's enough room there. Rossi presents his stick. Chicago gets lost. And a nice little finish from Marco Rossi for his second.
On this offensive zone draw, Kaprizov wins a puck battle, centered it just out of the reach of Zuccarello. Spurgeon to Goligoski. Into the middle, Kaprizov across, they score! What a feed to Zuccarello! And it's 3-0 Minnesota!
And as it works its way up to the D, watch Kaprizov work to get up, and he directs traffic. He says, hey, go D to D. He knows he wants to pick this up on his forehand. He also knows where he's going with it before he catches it. Picks it up in stride, puts it into a passing spot, finds the lane, slides it over flat with a little spin. Beautifully on the tape of Matt Zuccarello.
Zuccarello in that opening period had a goal and an assist, extending his point streak to 9, his assist streak to 7. And Jones intercepts.
Well, just a lot of room in the neutral zone. I mean, you can come out 2-on-1 here.
Boldy moving in, fires, save, Mrazek rebound, and Kaprizov was denied by a kick save from the Chicago goaltender.
Pucks over the neutral zone to get up the ice quick, so it's a quick regroup into Boldy going on the attack, 2-on-1 here. Tries the shot, and then that bouncing rebound just over Boldy's stick to Kaprizov.
Fleury has it for Minnesota, leaves it for Merrill. Merrill spins away from Radish, walks right out front of his own net. It deflects right on goal where Mrazek tees it up. Rossi with a shot! Glove save by Mrazek. Rossi with a good look.
Kaprizov on the forecheck, one-man forecheck here. He just spins the defender around and then takes it off of him. Finds Zuccarello, one-touch pass to Marco Rossi. Korchinski, the guilty party, turning that one over.
Leaves it for Faber. Kaprizov on the loose puck. Penalty coming against Chicago.
There's the second hook. Step aside.
Eriksson tied up by Vlasic. Got it to Boldy in behind. Now for Kaprizov. Out to the line, Spurgeon. Zuccarello takes a look. Fire, score! Boldy got a piece of it on the way, it appears. And the power play goal. Minnesota up by four.
Zuccarello in the spot he holds on the power play because he makes the right decision more often than not. He's given the shot there. He's got a lane. He puts it in a spot where his teammate out front can do something with it. That's Boldy off the stick. Nice tip. Boy, that's not an easy tip either. Body facing the net.
Three in a row against the Central, nine in a row against the West. Kaprizov carries in. It's a 3-on-1. Kaprizov fires, save Mrazek.
Kaprizov, that created the 3-on-1. Kaprizov decided shot was the best course of action. Rebound out to the last couple of games. Look at Nashville. The season average, just under 4 odd man rushes per game. Nashville, 11. Tonight, I should say this afternoon, 7 already.
Kaprizov and Zuccarello each had a crack at it.
The amount of space that this group needs to create a play is getting smaller and smaller.
2-on-1 for Chicago the other way. And a sliding save by Fleury. Two saves on 22 shots. Preserving the shutout for now. 4-0. Bedard in behind for Tyler Johnson. Kurashev pressured by Foligno. Radish. In behind, Tyler Johnson out to Bedard. Bedard looking back for Johnson. Tried to center, Radish with a deflection, and he scores.
Off of Marc-Andre Fleury. I don't think there's going to be goaltender interference, but they go high to low. The Wild get running around a little bit. Jake Middleton, his job there, long body, sealed a cross-ice pass. He doesn't do it, gets through him. Catches Radish off the backside, skating in.
Maroon shot. Goodrow on the rebound, looking for Foligno, who's tied up by Murphy. Foligno still down in the Chicago crease. Goodrow with it. Fires. Hit traffic out front. Maroon with a shot. Pad save Mrazek. Minnesota's had a road-heavy schedule so far this season. There's only two teams in the league that have played fewer home games than Minnesota. And when you consider that Eriksson Ek here stopped by Mrazek, that one of what technically counts as a Minnesota home game was played in Stockholm against Toronto. They've played 9 games here in this building coming into today. That would be tied for the lowest number of games in a home rink for any team in the league. And they've got a 4-game road trip coming up.
Well, that sets up well for them as they try to climb the West standings.
Boldy got it to Spurgeon, and a save by Mrazek.
Boldy's had a couple of those here tonight. Nice pickup spinorama. Leaves this one for Jared Spurgeon. Looking for his patented spot, short side glove. Good communication there. Mrazek.
Awful.
But they've earned that confidence.
A thorough domination by Minnesota. 3 first period goals, and they coast to a 4-1 win over the Hawks.